Okay.
Boom.
All right. Let's move this microphone over here, which I should have done before we did that. But hey, now we're, oh boy. Sure. There we go. Now it's pointing it sort of between us instead of over us.
Yay.
Hey, everybody.
Hello.
Okay. We have a boss fight. We have a boss to fight. Apologies again. Wow, that was bassy. That must have been... Yep, it sure was. Senstaku with a 22-month resub. Welcome back, Senstaku, and thank you for 22 months of support. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
I feel bad about last time. I got, like, triple booked, and I had a business call at 6, which was a stupid idea. I didn't realize we'd be playing the boss fight at 6.
Right then, yeah.
So that was bad. So sorry that I had to be like, oh, goodbye!
And especially sorry to you, Kaus Jason and Cramburger.
With your 6 and 2 month resubs respectively, and welcome back, and thank you.
So, I feel like a Cramburger is like, that's the burger that they make you at the end of the night.
Mm-hmm.
That's just, it's like ground beef and other things.
Whatever's on hand.
Yeah, it's just like, we don't have anything to put.
All right. Let us do this.
All right. So, let's get some audio back. Boom. This ain't no game.
Valkarian Chronicler has a subscribe. That is a new subscriber. Valkarian Chronicler, welcome and thank you. And Genkidama666 with a new sub. Another new subscriber. Welcome and thank you. Right, this part. Ah, crap. I guess I'm happy that we're helping you, I guess, Clever Crumbish. I don't know if that counts as help. Ass. Got there.
Oh yeah, we're not doing the FPS thing. Shit.
Oh, are we not?
No.
Oh no. Aha! This time I went left, like people told me to do.
Do you want to, do you want to, go offline and quickly come back?
I guess we could do that, yeah. Who plays the voice of Derek? Derek doesn't talk, if you mean the Warriors character.
Yeah, we're not on... I can confirm
balls.
We are not on 60 FPS. Although, interestingly enough, on our screen, on the stream here, it looks like we were actually in sync. In the sense that when you got hit, you were solid instead of invisible.
Weird.
But anyway... so, do you want to restart?
Sure.
Or turn? Okay, we're going to go offline real quick, and then we'll be back even quicker.
Whoop, nope. I died anyway.
Look at that 60 FPS dancing.
Ha ha!
There's so much more movement now.
Yeah. all the frames.
You can really see the depth and elegance of his dancing.
Okay.
Also, you're for some reason a lot better at this.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Oh, okay.
You ruined Maybe not. I gotta not be in the air on those last ones. Just the one, Sanubis. The one that you just saw now. Ah.
It's true.
Ah, balls.
The floor is lava.
It's really hard.
There's the stealth thing that makes.
I don't know if that would work for this. I'd be willing to try it though.
Won't they just go through you then? There's also bad.
Oh, well, that's awesome. Alright.
Yay for that.
I like that.
Alright, now this malarkey. I'm trying to remember what a good strategy was for the actual boss lady. I don't think we really encountered anything particularly good. Ah! This is a place full of lies.
Oh, wow.
Oh, huh. They're just like, you know what? This is the end of the game anyway, who cares?
Pretty much.
Oh. Filling up your health actually is kind of handy. And a fish!
Goodbye. Neat. So I'm gonna lose those gems, but the music pages will be handy.
Also, just going into this fight with totally full life is always nice, rather than just being like down by a couple hits.
Well, I mean, I'm not gonna beat it the first try, so we're gonna go back to that checkpoint. Go balls! Got there. Whoa.
Alright. You are useless!
At what?
Those candles.
Yeah.
Those candles are lighting themselves and that is it. It's the worst.
Okay. Now then. This part.
So you've got that equipped. Is that what you want?
I can't remember.
Trying to remember what combination of weapons was the right one. I remember you don't actually have the one that people were suggesting.
So I did eventually beat this form, and then there was a checkpoint before the last form, which is good.
Yeah, but unfortunately we had to end.
That wasn't it. I think it was lob casings? Oh no, it wasn't lob, because lob just ruins the floor.
Yeah, I remember the time you beat her, you just got into a good situation where you were just able to, like, pound when she was... when she was coming up one of her moves.
Yeah, goodbye.
Bye. Right.
Maybe it was lob. Alright. It wasn't float casing, though. Whoops. Did not mean to pick tracer powder.
I mean, I guess float casing plus spark or something would be kind of interesting, because then you wouldn't actually be damaging the ground. But I don't think that's a good idea. Yeah. Lob plus spark, V bad.
Yeah.
V bad.
That was the bad one. It was the spark casing just, like, made all the floor go away.
Or spark powder.
Spark powder, yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. That's the one where you need the quick fuse.
Wow.
To make that work properly. As we've established, if she would just stop bringing the floor back, she could beat the. She could win this fight pretty easily, considering she can fly and you can't.
Yep. Ah. Damn it. I don't think it's gonna be this time. Gotta get my groove back. Which is to say, gotta find a groove. And then pretend I always had it. Alright, getting there.
I feel like it's positive that you died from damage rather than falling down a hole. I don't know why.
It's not. I'm not using the long fuse, I'm using the impact fuse. So it blows when it hits her.
Yeah. Well, they blow when it hits anyway, but it also blows when it hits the ground with the impact fuse.
Yeah, but, I mean, if it doesn't hit her, it's going to do that anyway.
Yeah. And you don't... Yeah. The recommendation here is the quick fuse, but you don't have that, so...
Yeah.
Such is life.
Ah. Nope. Ah, no, my timing was... I got a couple hits on her down there.
Yeah,
my timing was sort of off. But not what I meant to do.
You don't think, what do you call the combo bomb would be good against her?
I don't think so.
I guess the level 3 explosion could be too damaging on the ground.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually.
Huh.
Terrible. Whoops.
Good luck with that, Therabus.
Whoopsies.
He's going to his first GP this weekend.
Wait, they're actually doing another one with Spectre Knight?
Yeah, well, they've said they're going to do... I mean, I guess it all depends on, you know, various economic factors, but I think they intend to do a bunch of these. Although, I mean, at a certain point, they aren't going to be able to just keep delivering them for free.
Yeah.
I mean, this... By all rights, this should have been full, like, an actual... I mean, it wouldn't... It's a lot of the same level, so I wouldn't expect it to be super expensive, but this definitely could have been a paid thing.
Yeah, I was surprised.
Like, $5.
I thought it was, which is why people were like, hey, there's a Shovel Knight DLC out. You should go get it and play it. And I couldn't find it.
Yeah, we were like, looking for the DLC... And it was just, no, it's just an update to the
show. It's like, no, you just go play the game.
King Knight and Spectre Knight are both going to be released for free, apparently. So close! Nice! Nice! Get there!
From the bowels of hell.
All right, you're at 2.
Yeah, I know.
Be careful. You've got a couple of the... Tonics.
She's very close.
You've got the absorbing power stuff too. Although the
my timing is always off. That relies on me hitting her, and if I hit her 2 more times,
you win anyway.
I win anyway. So.
And the vat is
crap.
Very handy.
Oh,
so close.
No. Oh well. Oh, they're Kickstarter stretch goals. I had no idea.
Oh, wow.
I actually didn't know this game was kickstarted.
That's a long lead time on that. I mean, considering Shovel Knight has been out for a while now. Like a year?
Yeah. I mean, game dev, right?
Yeah, I know. It's just... that is, I guess, very forward-thinking... that they had it, some, they had like a thing that they were planning on doing. I guess maybe they were planning on doing it sooner, but
yeah. What? This is a good place for that. Thank you.
The vat can hit her when she is below you.
The vat does damage?
It explodes when it drops. I don't know if that's actually that relevant, but it could be interesting.
I was really hoping for a couple incidental hits there.
I know.
I'm doing pretty well in terms of damage output.
But...
ah, my damage intake is pretty high also.
Yeah, you're kind of equaling her. Which is not necessarily the best place to be.
No. No, it's not.
I don't think you're going to use your tonic. No.
Oh, I almost... she paused there. No. I probably could have, but I only have two left, so...
Orbit case... switching to orbit casing, right? The thing is, you... when you switch to orbit casing, you then have to throw the bombs. You don't just get it.
The problem with orbit casing also is that then they just hit the ground and blow up.
Right, and just blow up the ground under you, right? We tried that.
Yeah.
Dan Targon! Thank you for subscribing!
There we go.
Nice. Dan Targon, for subscribing for 18 months in a row.
Welcome back, Dan Targon.
Dan Targaryen of the House Targaryen.
Over here. No, damn it. No, no. Oh. So close. Come over here.
Boom. Nice!
There we go. Okay. Oh, we know there's a second form.
Yeah, we've seen the second form.
But there's a checkpoint there, which is good. So.
And this... the second form is an actually totally new boss.
Yeah, it's not... I mean, it's not her second form. It's just the second half of the boss fight. But it's not her. It's actually... it's me! It's my nega form. I'm going to eat this muffin while this cutscene happens.
And then your nega form is going to eat a nega muffin.
Oh, whoops.
Right, there's also a third stage. Which we've seen, too. That's
right.
It's you, but it's giant.
That's what I was thinking of. I obviously forgot the intermediary stage.
Yeah, there's one that's just shadow version of you. But he's a dick, because he actually... you know, switch... can, like, switch to all the different casings and powders really fast.
Oh, hi. Sorry, thank you. That was UPS.
Yay.
We came all the way inside.
Also, he can do that. Yeah, see, the vats do explode.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, you have that being used against you. Alright, you have to think.
What
think like
I
yourself.
Do?
What do you hate the most? If only you could set up a situation where you're standing on a little teeny weeny platform that he has to jump onto.
Yeah, exactly.
Or you could just throw a bomb on him as he tries to do the jump. You got one hit. No hits.
I don't think it's going to be this time. I beat that guy first try last time.
Mm. And now, but now you're at full life, though.
Mm-hmm. Ah, I'm not actually connecting with any of those.
Oh, yeah. Your range is just slightly off. Ah, nice. There we go. Just jumped into it. Yeah, when do you get the teleport move?
Right?
Nice. You blow up his vat in his face. And then he blew it up in your face. Hmm. Just in combo bomb for this one, maybe?
Yeah, maybe, yeah. I can't actually remember what I used last time.
Combo bombo?
Someone in chat was saying that, speaking of someone who has beaten Rogue Legacy, that it was painful to watch me get hit so much. Which,
I'm sure it's probably painful for Plague Knight, too.
Yeah. I mean, I never claimed to be good at games like Shovel Knight and Rogue Legacy. I just enjoy them.
Tenacity. Still using the impact fuser.
Am I not?
No, you are using it.
Yeah. I think in this case it was bad.
Wow, that is effective.
Yeah, this one's way better. The collateral hit from the explosion. Yeah. He's changed to my casing. Also, if you notice that, he was using... Oh, no, now he's using... That was a lock casing. His menu management is really good.
Yeah.
Menu micro. Ah, get away. Oh, come on.
You're so close.
What? Also, his range seems not okay. Oh, come on. Just one more hit. Not on me, on you.
There. One of those bombs almost definitely would have hit you. Hopefully there's another checkpoint here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is. We worked this out last time.
All right.
So something I was trying to figure out.
Sunder is smashing his pink thing there. In this case, you might want to actually have a bouncy, something with a longer fuse. So you can bounce it into it?
Yeah.
Or maybe
they're
that's
not
too
doing
low.
Anything.
Oh, the bird blocks it.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
So you do have to hit it high.
Nah.
Spark powder, someone said. That could be good.
Alright. I'll try it. Oh, wow, yeah. It's pretty good on him, too. Okay. And he put out less exploding monas that time as a result.
Less exploding monas is good. Maybe why you can get
this
in some
good
hits.
This is
good.
I like this a lot.
Well, you get in some good hits here. Oh, you changed
boy.
To a different move.
I tried to jump over that.
Might want to try the absorbing stuff. Get some health back.
That is a good idea.
Leech liquid. I always forget it. I'm like absorbing powder stuff.
Wow, yeah, I gained a lot there.
Boom!
Wow, okay. Whoever suggested spark powder, good job!
Yeah.
I know that he only takes damage when his mouth is open.
Mona!
Well, that was quick.
You did it! The reaction has stabilized.
Yay! The
ultimate
potion.
Ultimate potion.
I have no idea.
No. Use a whole bunch of.
Oh.
Wait. Leave first!
Run away!
I'm trying to remember, in Shovel Knight, does the tower explode hugely?
I have no idea.
At the end? I can't try to remember that. I like that their plan is that they'll make the tower explode in a huge, impressive way, and that'll make everyone want to hang out with them. It's like, to me... Oh, here we go. Boss time, or the
no, this is
credit
the
times.
Credits, yeah. Knighted by the king! Oh, right, the real king, not King Knight.
Knighted by... the triple pawn! Oh, hey! That weird song-playing guy. I'm glad he found somewhere to hang out.
Yeah. Somewhere away.
The Lich Yard from Spectre Knight.
Whoa.
He's not happy.
Interesting. Interesting.
Ah.
He's one of the people you get to play as. Meanwhile, down inside the Iron Whale.
We're stealing all his stuff. Oh, it's Treasure Knight. Oh, poor Treasure Knight. Treasure was all he had! The Explotorium. Yeah, you guys!
Everyone's just having a blast.
Aha!
No! Percy the Magicist and the Hedgehog? So Plague Knight's just taken over.
Yep. Cooperative cloning.
Excuse me?
Oh.
Interesting.
Because those used to be only in Plague Knight's area.
Wow.
Wandering Traveler.
Get fought, you guys.
Oh yeah, that guy.
That guy on the far right I never fought in this playthrough.
No. You could have, but you just avoided him.
Yeah.
What's going on with Tinker Knight? Tweaking the torque lifts. Oh, right, because the lift that goes down to your place makes everybody sick to their stomach all the time.
Polar Knight and the Black Knight.
Reunited.
Hanging out.
Oh, because he's stranded on the ship. Nice. Propeller Knight, back to being a meter D. That's right.
Ah. A real horseman.
Yeah. Is this Power Rangers? There's science to be done! Prequel to Portal?
Do I get to control this or what? No?
Yay!
Dance!
Victory!
So good.
Yeah, Tinker Knight would be awesome to play as.
Just little guy.
I mean, heck, I wouldn't play. I'd like to play with as any of them.
Yeah.
Like, it's a beautiful idea with the, like, because the different mechanics change the game so much.
Mm-hmm. Gosh, Jason, what did I hear about Power Rangers? Just hanging out at the juice bar.
Yeah, that was always where they would hang out.
It was a combat mode?
Well, yeah. Yeah, it's true, but I mean, I'm more interested in how they actually, in terms of the level design and stuff.
Hmm.
Shield Knight would be interesting. You never actually see her
like
fight.
I'm trying to remember if these were, like, these weren't identical levels, were they?
Yeah, they were. I think
they work really well.
I mean, they may have, like, maybe added a few things, but I think the basic design of the levels was almost exactly the same.
It's just that Shovel Knight and Plague Knight control so differently. Like, they're mechanically, like, very, very different characters for just how they navigate.
Identical except for green areas.
Not identical, but similar. No, Sonata, I really want to see that. The AGDQ run with the developers on the phone, not only is the speedrun cool, the devs talk about making the game. I love stuff like that. I also like watching when devs call into AGDQ because they're usually sitting there going, what are you doing to our game?
Oh yeah, so they move some of the platforms and stuff around because of
the bomb jump.
Jumping works right. Differently.
Well, I know the point was to have a different game. I'm just saying, I'd be frankly astonished if they could make these levels work, be as challenging for Shovel Knight and Plague Knight without changes, considering how differently they control.
Yeah.
Oh no. Ha! Iron Whale, eat it. Yeah, that adds up. Here you go, Anubis. Here's a complete list. If this doesn't match with your number, then...
Well, total lives lost 149.
There you go.
But we're combining the two, though, so... Have to remember what it was actually at the end of Shovel Knight.
Oh, that's true. 66%? Oh, item completion, okay.
It's just... You did miss a lot of the green coins.
That's true.
You cast screw those green coins.
Two-player prequel game with Shovel Knight and Shield Knight? That'd be sweet.
Mm. I think with Shovel Knight and Shield Knight, I'm imagining, like, something like The Lost Vikings.
Oh, darn it. Anubis had 146. Curses. Yay.
Yay, now they're dancing.
The room's filled with fog.
Also, I like that, I love that Plague Knight is actually doing the dance that he was practicing.
Yeah.
He's just doing it with somebody else. Oh, the dip.
The dip. Mono Snorsh. Rhythm Tuesdays, now appearing Wednesdays at noon. Is that's the full name of the show. Is Ian and Heather are filling in for Kathleen, and they're playing rhythm games. Today they played Rhythm Thief for 3DS, and did they play Samba de Amigo as well?
I'm not sure.
Or is that on the future plan?
I remember I didn't know they spent a lot of time laughing at whatever game it was.
Hmm.
Some fancy moves. I think this is just loops.
Love it.
just Rhythm Thief.
Got there. challenge mode. This is probably a bad idea. These are like... Oh no. I didn't know these things existed. Oh.
Good start.
I don't think I have the float.
Alright, you've got 20 seconds to.
Oh! Okay!
30 seconds to do the whole thing.
Yeah, no, that's not happening.
This seems like a really frustrating jumping puzzle. So, maybe we should play some Mario Maker instead.
Yeah, I think that's gonna happen.
Speaking of which, I actually... I was just reading today about, about some other cool Mario Maker levels. Chozo Hybrid, thank you for subscribing for 14 months in a row. What's this one?
I have to get 1900 gold before time runs out.
G-Dwarf, I don't think that... I saw that and I'm super excited, but I don't think the that update has actually come out yet.
The checkpoints?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's November 5th or something.
Yeah, update to... Yeah, no. Update to Mario Maker is forthcoming, where two big changes that people were asking for. One, mid-mission checkpoints. And I love the actually, could you switch back to Booth?
Booth!
The video where they announced this, they also showed a checkpoint, like, right over some spikes, so that if you start at the checkpoint, you immediately fall into spikes. And it's like, yeah, not only do you have to beat the level before you can upload it, you also have to beat it starting at every checkpoint. And the other thing was progressive pickups.
Pickups that change depending on what you currently have?
Yeah, so if you take a fire flower and then you add a mushroom to it and you put that combination thing into a question block... Then if you're Baby Mario, you'll get a mushroom, and if you're Big Mario, you'll get a fire flower, like in the games.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's pretty sweet.
So, this is I was reading this article today.
Mm-hmm.
So for one thing, somebody made a checkpoint system.
In Mario Maker?
In Mario Maker.
How?
It's ridiculous, but I think we should try it.
Okay.
And then...
Wait, they, like, programmed it?
Sort of. They basically made a password save system.
That's amazing.
Yeah. And then somebody also did, like, a boss attack thing. It seems pretty cool. So, okay. Anyway, there's a couple things we could try.
All right, let's do that. So, first of all, I'm going to do this so that we can get Mario Maker on this monitor. In case you haven't picked up on it, we're playing Mario Maker now. And then we'll have to change this. I'll let you take care of that. And then I will... Or I guess you can... Is it not? Oh, you got to do some stuff on the back?
It's not plugged in.
You got to go around the back? Okay. Well, I will do this.
It's plugged in right now.
We'll start a new game next time. But for now, it's Mario Maker times.
We can, you know, there are some also more fan things.
Getting warm in here. Thanks, Clever Crumbish. I appreciate the hashtags. Littlefinger, yeah, the replays are caught up. Forgot we had a cat paw. Let me just change this back to 1080 before I forget. The computer, not us. Oh, wait, what?
Oh, because when I unplugged it, it reset.
Oh, well, that's handy.
I guess we'll be playing Mario at 60 frames a second.
Whatever.
Or we'll be broadcasting it. We're still capturing it. All right, whatever.
Nightvalian, yes. There won't be any streams. I don't know. There probably won't be any streams in basically the week prior to Desert Bus. But then during Desert Bus, you get a solid week of streaming, so, you know, there's a trade-off.
In case it isn't obvious, there won't be streams during Desert Bus.
Yeah, just like last year.
And leading up to Desert Bus, we might do some stuff.
Let me turn the console back up. Or wait. Oh, no, there it is.
So, let me see.
Ooh, that's out of sync. It's doing the out of sync thing. You need to refresh it in XSplit. There we go.
So where's the...
Oh yeah, can I use this?
Should be able to.
I remember we did this before. I need the Luigi Wiimote. The Luigimote. Luigimote! Desert Bus Hyper! Yeah, there will be streams during Desert Bus. The streams will be called Desert Bus. What got Adam to start the 365 challenge? James sort of badgered him into it.
Yeah, I was going to say it was probably... I think he just did it for fun, but it was also James.
Yeah, no, it just certainly wasn't for fun.
James is an enabler. All right, so there are a couple... There's...
What's this one?
You're just doing random...
I don't know. Well, you're looking stuff up.
All right.
This one's got very high votes.
This looks dangerous. Those red ones are heat seeking, right?
Dang it. Do I believe the arrows? Do I not believe the arrows?
It's like, now you're small, but it's slower. Now you're small, but it's slower. So do those not fire at all? He's just using them as smashing blocks?
Yep.
You could go through there.
I could, but then I can't come back.
You can go back up the top.
I'm just curious. All right, let's try the door. Whoa! That's a very big one of those.
Oh dear.
Uh oh. Dead. Oh, got there.
It's basically an auto-scrolling level.
Wow, that's a unique way of doing that.
Also, that chain chum's just kind of hanging like that. Poor Thwomp. He was a little overzealous.
He lives to die.
Oh, this is a really complicated level. It's kind of cool, though.
Oh, wait. This is where I came from. That last time. Or no, is it? Yeah, it is.
What? I'm so confused.
So that way I went before was a shortcut. Oh, boy.
What's over to the left?
Even more stuff? No, this is where it starts. Alright. Whoop! Oh, no. I knew there was some stuff down there. Alright, well that's fine then. I can just skip right to there. This level's sweet. Yeah, truly creative levels in Mario Maker are a little more difficult to find.
But again, there are a lot of levels in Mario Maker, so. Yeah. That's a way shortcut.
Uh-oh. Nope. I can tell I'm being chased. No. I'm being chased by that big one. I gotta just twerk it through there.
Yeah. Just twerk it through.
That's not quite what I said.
Pretty sure that's what you said.
Not a chance, Splash from Iridan. I was watching, what's his name? Panga. I was watching him stream and build a level. And. Goodness me.
The monster?
Oh, yeah. Got there. Some of the stuff he does, I'm like, gonna die. Definitely gonna die.
Yeah.
Some of the stuff he does mechanically is just. Like it, I feel like it's not supposed to work like that.
I mean, it's not. I mean, he's certainly doing things. Oh, all right. Well, let's see what's over here.
I was just curious what was in here. Oh, I see.
It's just a little. There's a one up there, yes.
Crap.
Damn you, ice.
Oh,
so close.
Oh, this is really, really challenging. I like it, but it's really difficult.
I love that both of those walls are just coated with deaths. It's just like a... It's just like a slick of previous Mario blood on all those walls.
What am I... What phrase am I using? Oh, whoops. That's not the way I'm meant to go. Oh, well. Oh, boy. Uh-oh. Got there.
Nice. Not so nice. Bye. Have a nice trip.
Wait, why are these ones so out of sync now?
I don't know. Eric the Orange, yes,
oh,
I do.
Oh, torquing it. Is that really Canada specific?
Torquing?
Yeah.
Torquing it? I don't know.
Yes, there will be more sick riffs. We have a couple in production. I'm sorry that they aren't out yet, but
some other things have kind of jumped in front of it in the queue.
No, that's not. Oh boy.
Nice.
Shit. Oh hey.
Boom.
Nice.
Ah, and it fires a coin for you.
Hooray!
I can't recall hearing that phrase outside Graham.
Huh. At
least... Did you hear that phrase inside Graham?
Yeah. If anyone heard the phrase inside me, we gotta talk about it.
Alright. Here is... I'll give you the code here.
Alrighty. That's not the right button. Go for it.
Code is 1B6D6 0s. A3FD76. I wonder how long it'll be until there aren't the six zeros in the middle anymore.
Junior Airship Showdown by Ragnarok X. Huh. Okay.
I don't scroll.
No, the airships just go up and down.
All right. Yoshi.
Damn it. I really wanted... Wow. I wanted him to blow up.
It looks like
things.
That might be harder than he thought.
Yeah.
What about the other pipe?
Hmm. Who knows? Oh, it wants me to go this way. I guess that's easier. Oh my god. That's embarrassing. All right.
So Doctor Who Crapshot, why not use the Sonic Screwdriver Wiimote? Because the whole point is that it's not a real, that it's just a regular screwdriver.
It's a screwdriver. He's West Country Doctor Who. He uses a screwdriver. He's a practical man.
As Captain Jack says, who looks at a screwdriver and says, that should be more Sonic.
Yeah. Wow. I don't know why I'm dying on the easy stuff.
I mean, I could offer a suggestion as to why you're dying on the easy stuff. I feel like it wouldn't be appreciated.
I value your restraint.
Aha, loser.
All right. Nope, too far. Oh, come on. I'm trying to just get it and put it down.
You just have to hold down when you do that, right?
Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
Easy come, easy go.
That was funny. Burnt Riviera with a 15-month resub. Welcome back, Burnt Riviera.
Worst vacation spot ever.
Yeah. Ah, the Burnt Riviera.
Oh, Solomia! It burns! Double explosion!
I assume this is worth it. So, is that part of the checkpoint system? Is this the one with the checkpoint system?
Yes.
Good, because I just fell off.
That wasn't... I don't think you got to a checkpoint.
I know.
I'm pretty sure it'll become clear when you get to a checkpoint.
All right, well, what's this way?
Ah, this would be the checkpoint. So the things down along the bottom are what those indicate.
Yeah, this was the symbol I found. So now where do I go?
I think it's multiple.
It was a fire flower and a one up.
I don't know.
Wait. Oh, these. Right, those stuff. Okay. This is fascinating.
I'm assuming it will become clear. Maybe you should try just going past this part.
Yeah, you're probably right. I'm really curious now.
So there's one up and flower.
Yeah, that doesn't work there, though.
It doesn't do anything.
No. All right, let me just try and actually just walk. And by walk, I mean, like, not... All right, well... Whatever.
Didn't tell you that one. That was a stupid mushroom.
Ah!
What the?
Super interested by this entire thing. Behind that door.
Yeah. It's a Bowser copter. Isn't it?
Oh, this must be how they stop you going back through the doors.
So oh.
That must be one of the checkpoints.
Interesting.
Ah, there it is. Look, trampoline pow. You see that up there?
Oh, okay.
What the?
Oh, boss.
Hello. Another mushroom coming up if I can.
Oh, that's really cool. The, like conveyor belt.
Yeah.
Bouncy mushroom. How did you make that happen, I wonder?
I don't know.
Oh, okay, so pow skull.
Spiny thing.
Pow skull spiny thing.
OF. No, that's not what I wanted to do.
Oh dear. This reminds me a lot of Plague Knight.
in a way that I'm not super thrilled about.
Use your bomb jump.
Damn it.
Okay.
I guess so, I gotta spin jump those guys?
It was...
Pow, skull, spiny thing.
Right.
So, I don't know if the order matters. Blue skull, specifically.
Now what? Wait, something's going on.
Aha!
Aha! Nice. Wow.
That's crazy.
I like that he did all that and then also had to actually make like a real level. Like that's as complicated as some levels are.
That's way more complicated.
Boss area. Okay.
So it's ice, fire, flower, and donut thing.
Ice, fire, flower, donut. Man. Bowser Jr. is a little poop.
Gib, mushroom. No! What's, give mushroom!
What's shrinking you?
What? Oh, they're killing me. I'm getting hit by stuff.
Oh.
I don't know if what I'm doing is... Hang on, what am I supposed to actually be... Oh. That's okay, because we have the password.
So, ice flower donut. I guess there are only two checkpoints.
That's still pretty amazing. Okay, what am I supposed to be doing here? Oh, okay, there's actually a thing there to destroy with.
That little Tetris block there. There you go, perfect.
Give mushroom. Ah, dang it. Oh no, I need more. There we go. That should be well placed.
You need one more.
No!
No!
Okay, this level is beyond red. See, the doorbell goes off.
I kind of want to hear what's going... I want to see what's going on up the top.
You can open... Levels that you've played, you can open in the editor. Like, you can download them and play around with them.
I think you can do that even if you haven't played the level. But...
Yeah, that's fair.
Nice. And then one more.
I think so, yeah.
Boom! Oh no! I have to fight him for real! And the whole place is collapsing! Escape! Go, Yoshi!
I got the Yoshis out!
Oh, and the flag's right there. The thing is covered.
The Yoshis escaped! that was sweet.
Super neat. Ragnarok X.
That was crazy. So, hang on. Okay, how do you play or edit levels?
Well, you just you can download it. Yeah, you don't have to actually beat it to download.
Yeah, I don't know why. So I just want to look a little bit into this. Can you just go away?
Creep.
Okay. Ah, no.
You should be able to scroll around. There he is. No, that's the boss. How do you scroll up? Wah! What the hell's that? I don't know what's happening. It's like a background chunk.
I'm just trying to find the... Oh, the arrow buttons. Of course they are.
Oh, right. Duh. All right. Do you zoom out?
Where the hell? Also, this whole room is very impressive.
What's the zipper thing there?
It's fire.
Oh, right. Through a pipe in the subworld.
Oh, whoops.
Oh, is there... You can do sub...
Damn. None of this is what I wanted to do.
It's got layers.
I know. I just trying to... I don't actually know how to navigate. Oh, I actually have to drag Mario into the pipe? You know what? Let's just do this.
Okay. So, it's sort of like a, it's like a music box or something, right?
Okay, so when I was hitting ice, fire, flower, donut or whatever.
Yeah.
It would knock up so that this, so that the, this guy here would jump up here, and then the fire flower, this one would jump up here, and then the donut would make this guy jump up here. So then when I hit one of these switches, the trampoline falls and hits the spiny. Which then, hang on, can I make P-blocks? Wow, I don't have anything. Hang on.
Whedon Project, thank you for subscribing for 11 months in a row.
Welcome back, Whedon Project.
Yeah, so that allows it...
It clears this level and that one goes, but that one's stuck in there.
Yeah.
Easy. That's really, really interesting.
Huh. All right.
Well, there you go. Welcome back, Whedon Project.
All right, so there's another one here that looked kind of cool.
Alrighty. Bring it on.
All right. 8 BFE. 6 zeros.
All right.
72. 72.
Okay.
6930. But before we do that, I think we should probably take a quick commercial break.
Before we say go 7 boss rush?
Yes. All clear right. Rate 4%. Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
All right. We will see you guys in just a few minutes.
Yeah, we're going to run a quick break and play some commercials. Appreciate it if you let those run. And we'll be right back to play Go! 7 Boss Rush. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Bye. Wait, no. Not bye.
Hi.
Oh. Hi.
Sorry that was a little longer.
Break. Oops, sorry. Also.
Wow. Wow.
Just bike yourself in the nose with the...
Yeah. Things. Paul had stepped on the... Inadvertently, don't worry. He'd stepped on the headphone cable. So I'm putting the headphones up to my head. And they don't go... They stopped right here. So all the force just went... Right to my nose, and my glasses fell off.
Best day ever.
Wow. Right then, let's play Mario Maker. So what levels? Right, go 7 boss rush. Why do I have to 7 bosses? Oh, come on, Wiimote.
Why not?
I'm curious if this is cool presentation or yeah, okay.
It's worthwhile checking it out.
This one. Yay.
So,
I'll take it.
So you can see. So what it is, from reading the article, what it is you get a choice.
Oh, it tells you what's in them.
Yeah, it's like, what tool do you want to bring into battle with you?
Oh.
For the boss rush. It shows you what's going to be in each place, too.
All right, giant Goomba. Let's do it.
Doesn't sound so scary. Whoa! That was not what I expected. Have fire. Oh. What is happening?
So after a certain amount of time, the big one
gets destroyed.
Well, no, I jumped on it.
No, but the place to get to the big one opens up. All right.
Okay. What is?
Oh, you? Oh.
Huh?
I think you need to.
Is there something in there I had to do?
Yeah. No. Just like, try going back through. Oh, you have to do that all again. Darn it.
Probably, but it's okay.
I think you get made large there, and then you have to hit a block.
Oh, to unlock the... Oh, well, this is already gone, so...
Oh. That fucked up.
Got there!
I don't think that was supposed to happen. Oh, cause... Oh, no. No. Didn't get there.
Oh.
What's happening? I think something might have messed up.
Alright, well, I'll just do the other bosses. I mean, that was only the first two, so... I've used the fire flower. Alright. Okay, I won't go up there then.
It doesn't seem like something. Alright. Wizard dudes.
Damn it. Whoa.
Nice. How many you have to take out? Or is this the real one?
I think I had to activate that thing. Balls.
Activate what thing?
The thing I just stepped on.
Oh. They're teleporting like crazy.
Right, because... Ah, no. Because it needs to be here so that I can stand on it to open the door.
Oh, I see. So you just have to last. Until it drops down there.
There's a boo now.
What the?
Well, just okay. To get me out of there.
So now, so get the mushroom and then hit the block there.
Look, it's not perfect system. Okay.
Oh I feel like that wasn't what was supposed to happen there.
Yeah, I'll do a different boss for now.
Alright, Mole Man. Mole Man, also Ray. Seems like a strong choice for this guy. What's the... Something's gotta happen to destroy those blocks. You have to use the jump. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I like that the use of the confetti thing to let you know that you're doing the right thing. Nice. There you go.
All right. Who's this? Who cares? Let's do it.
Bullet Bills.
Okay.
Helmets are good.
What are you?
Why did it have wings?
It goes faster if it has wings.
Oh, I see. So your head invincible, but not body invincible.
Balls. Oh boy. Oh. Okay. Okay. Okay.
Problem is, this does not have checkpoints.
That's okay.
So spoiled now. I want checkpoints everywhere.
I know. Still a big fan of Fire Flower.
Try somewhere else.
Yeah, I just want to see what all the bosses are. Uh-oh. Ah! Oh, hell.
It's a tough one.
Yeah. Okay, I think I get how to beat that one, but I'm gonna go check on the one with the bloopers as well.
Oh. I hate bloopers.
I know, me too.
It's like a blooper on a chain. Uh-oh. Bowser, you're not a blooper.
Also, why are you flying? Why did I jump? Wah! What the hell?
Oh, there's the bloopers. There's the bloopers.
What is happening?
I don't know. He uses that trick a few times, the bombs as a timer. Almost made it.
So that one I just have to survive?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, let's do this. Dilox 82! Dilox 82 with a 2-month resub! Welcome back, Dilox 82.
Welcome back.
Got the Kerbo shoe, got the boot. What's this one?
Helmet.
And a coin. Alright. Let's do this.
The coin doesn't seem like that good a deal. What if you stay, like, right hidden behind that? Oh no, let's go through those, okay? I was like, it'll be great, that block will block his fireballs as a fireball goes through the block. I was like, whoops. Ooh, nice one. I don't think you can actually kill him with it. Can you?
You can definitely kill him with Fire Flower, yeah. Dang it!
Stupid bombs are such a waste. Two of them explode at the same time. Three of them explode at the same time and kill each other.
I mean, I think that's by design.
I know. But if they just came out slightly later, they would blast the hole way faster.
Oh, I still can't get through there.
Now you can. No, not yet. Alright. Go, go, go! No bloopers came out that time.
Yeah, weird.
Alright. One down.
Alright, let's try this hellscape.
I like the way they give it gives you little power-ups in each area.
Yeah.
Nice!
No!
Oh!
Wow. That one's brutal. I should probably do that one first. Actually, I have an idea.
Mmm. Good thought. Oh, what? Oh, there you go. Boom. Careful. Darn it. It was the middle. Control, damn you.
Seth Locke with the 21-month resub. Welcome back, Seth Locke. Thank you so much! Ooh. For why? Subscribing.
Why didn't they have the thing like right above you? Why make that a tough jump?
I don't know. Oh yeah, I don't even know how to beat this one. Oh well.
Chozo Hybrid. Talk to you later.
I mean, I have some ideas, but...
Remember, lead with your head.
Damn it!
Alright, stop leading with your head now.
Crap.
What's going on down there?
Hang on, I want to get...
Can you get your thing back?
Well, I can. I thought there was mushrooms down there. Are. Come back! Okay. So I gotta get another... Nope! Shitty balls!
Nice. Could've been worse. Nice. Alright, okay. Two down!
Oh, I thought I had three down. Have I not done the bloopers this time?
No. You don't want to get any... I guess you don't need anything for this.
Ooh. If I can make him smash this one, I get fire flowers out of it.
Alright, one more, and you're done. Stupid bubombs, blow up faster, damn you! Why are they blowing up? Okay.
And I'm
oh,
out.
I see, the new ones had come down in front of the one that was flashing.
Yeah, the level is called 7 Boss Rush, which makes me a little worried.
Well, it has to be like... the final boss.
Yeah. Alright, let's do... Wait,
no, you've done all these. You've done all three. So now you're on the other side. These ones seemed a little easier in general.
Let's do the moles. Howdy, sly guy. I mean, this one was easy with Fire Flower.
And you still have Fire Flower. So it's all good. I mean, you still have lots of stuff to choose from in your little arsenal there.
Mm-hmm.
Oops. Hey, he had wings.
If I If I were able to jump correctly, I'd be able to hit two blocks at once, but...
It's all good, it's all good. Alrighty. Two more. So we got... that guy and this guy. So these are both ones that you just have to wait on.
Yeah.
This guy wasn't too tough. Alright, I forgot about the music. Like, can you just stay up here?
That's my hope.
This doesn't seem very hard at all. I guess I'll have to go down there eventually. Wow. Nice. Can you just butt drop that? No, you can't butt drop him.
Can't butt drop in Mario 3.
Huh. That was easy.
I'll take it.
Alright, one more. The stupid wizards. Or stoopzards, as I call them.
Alright.
So this is another just wait for it.
Yeah, but...
but if you can take out that guy. I don't think you're gonna be able to do it with Fireball.
No, I think I will have to actually... Uh-oh, that's not what I meant to do!
How are you...
No, there was a feather!
That'll do it.
Really, really want a mushroom.
And there it is. I don't remember those guys teleporting that fast.
Oh boy.
No!
No!
Oh, oh good. Okay, you good. Can't come back. Yes!
Aha!
Alright, all six bosses taken care of.
Exactly. All
nothing to worry about.
In this level entitled Seven Boss Rush.
Yeah, six boss rush complete. What? That wasn't the name of the level? No, I'm pretty sure. I seem to recall it was called Six Boss Rush. Six ish. Six-ish boss rush.
Hut.
Right. I mean, who can count, you know?
What was that?
That was...
Incore Stardust!
Incore Stardust! New subscriber!
Brand new sub. Welcome
thank you
to
for
the
joining
channel.
Us.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
And oh, Bowser yeah. is on a track.
Because he's...
Oh, he's the one who's been doing that this whole time.
Yeah. Welcome. So, yeah, that is a brand new set. Welcome to the channel, Incore Stardust.
I feel kind of sorry for
I hope we're pronouncing the Incore part correctly. It's again, we don't get any capitalization on our end. So.
Ink or Stardust. Maybe. Ink or Stardust. Choose. Oh, dear. That is a not small Bowser.
Whoa! Oh.
You are low on time.
Oh.
Well, not that low.
Aha! Oh, it does say this is a game. Oh, it's Ink or Stardust? Alright, cool.
I believe.
You get a star! And then we're gonna play Musical Titanic. Because it was right there. I hope this plays Celine Dion.
This ain't no game. I believe you're fine.
Yep.
I don't actually know My Heart Will Go On. Simon Begoth! Is it, I like it. I like the people who jumped. Simon Begoth, thank you for subscribing. Johnny be good, but Simon Begoth. What's playing the music now?
Stuff off shot. Welcome back, Simon Begoth.
Oh, Yeah.
Go on.
It's very slow.
On.
Celine Dion's kind of taking it easy on that one. Ah! Oh, God, I thought that was a... thought that was an auto-scroll for a second. Yeah. I was like, that's so... the Titanic crash was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the Goombas are the drowning passengers of the Titanic.
Oh, no, you're right. Which one's Jack? All right. So should we just do some, should we just do a chorus rush? Let's do normal mode.
Good.
Expert levels are terrifying, so we're gonna play on normal. Because we're scrubs. Princess Peach is in trouble. What a fucking surprise.
You know, Princess Peach... If you let yourself get taken by two Goombas, seriously.
Two Goombas?
Yeah. We know that you can, like, fly and float and jump on guys and throw crap. You can take out two Goombas, I think. Whoa!
Oh, I assume that I'm not supposed to interact with this.
Hope not, because you ain't.
I didn't need those guys.
What? I love being shot by a springboard. I'm concerned as to why this isn't the medium difficulty thing.
Well, so the difficulties are based on, like, ratios of how many people have tried it and succeeded or failed.
See, that's what I mean. Why have people failed this one?
Presumably by trying to move at the beginning, I don't know.
Unless it's one of the ones where there's a dead, there's like a kill thing right at the very end.
So, I don't know, it's the chat seems very divided on automatic levels. I appreciate the engineering.
Yeah, I mean, they're not, it's not, you're not, like, playing a game, it's just sort of a thing to watch.
Yeah, which is neat.
Yeah.
Yoshi!
I got no problem with that. It's a, Rube Goldberg machine.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hey.
Super Mario World. No, Yoshi, I probably need you for this. Oh boy. Oh, I could have waited. I didn't know.
Damn you, Yoshi, with your invulnerable feet.
Why did Adam get so mad at autorunners? Was he trying to play them? Damn it, Yoshi. Alright. I feel like autorunners definitely aren't gonna work if you try to actually interact with them.
No. I like the way you blame Yoshi for that.
For abandoning me.
All that happened is you got hit.
Huh. Okay. Sometimes normal difficulty levels are not that challenging. Other times, normal difficulty levels are pretty cool. The problem is, all the expert levels are just misery.
Yeah. Why make... Alright, Adam was getting all salty. Why make a level if you're just gonna sit there and watch it?
Mm.
I mean, it's a different thing, right? It's like the, it's sort of like the checkpoint system, right? It's using... Right. Using the...
What the... I'm a Charizardman.
You're a Pokings man.
I'm a Pokings man.
Can you, like, blow fire or anything cool? No.
Nope. I'm Charizard.
You're multiple Charizards. Uh-oh. Oh, no, no longer.
I really wanted to do that.
But yeah, the auto players are just using using Mario Maker as a medium, as opposed to what? Oh, because you have to actually hit it. Nice. Huh. You can never go above 100, right?
Oh no. All right, well.
I guess we live here now.
I like that I can break blocks though, because it's
large.
I'm technically large.
Oh, nice! But you're small size.
Yeah.
Fancy.
Oh, do I strike a pose?
How do you do that?
I press up.
All you the make a little boogie noise.
Yeah, all the alternate costumes do a thing. Okay. What the f... Alright.
Damn you, one-up. Is this somehow a thematically a, Pokemon?
Good.
Is this somehow thematically a Pokemon thing?
If it is, I'm unaware of it, but then I don't play Pokemon, so. No, you don't stay powered up between levels, so anything that I would get in this level, I lose.
What are the three one-ups in the top?
I don't know, that you gain those over the course of playing a level, so. Ooh, I don't want to go in there and get the mushroom, I'll get trapped forever. Well, not really, I can, like. Yeah, but still.
I am a Pokemon, and I am a Pokemon, and I can confirm this is insane.
Ah!
Whoa! That's not a small number of dudes.
Bounce back, bounce back. Oh boy!
Sort of bad.
Yeah, got there.
Wow, that would have been a good level to do, like, later on when you're a little low in life.
Yeah.
Ah, I see.
Oh, you don't get the 1-ups until you beat the level, okay.
And you can only get a max of 3 1-ups.
Mmm, okay.
I guess, for that exact reason.
This is pretty much exactly what Pokemon is like, Graham. You're getting the full experience. Great! Does that mean I'm a...
Yeah, the only difference...
I'm a trainer now? Or I'm a gym guy?
Jimmy Jim Jim?
I'm a Jimmy Jim.
Oh! Double Yoshi! Triple Yoshi! Quadruple... Oh, no. Those Yoshis just turned into... Yoshi can't climb. Goodbye, Yoshi!
There's a door there.
Yoshi jump off.
I don't think that works. You have to be standing on something to use a door.
Confused as to what's going on here. Yoshi can stand on that.
Well,
I think it's just messing with you.
It's almost assuredly just messing with me.
Stop through.
What?
Oh no, you're stuck. No, you're not stuck. Are you stuck? Oh, there you go. Sort of. Oh, and then you're there. Okay.
Fizz Pivot with a 3-month resub. Welcome back, Fizz Pivot. I like that name.
Fizz Pivot. Ah.
I'll miss you, Yoshi.
I'll write letters.
I will write.
You can't read. It's a dragon.
That was lame. Dude. This level is called Dude. Dude.
Sergeant Obvious! Thank Sergeant, you for
Sergeant,
subscribing.
Sergeant Oblivious.
The opposite of Sergeant Obvious. Sergeant Oblivious really could use Sergeant Obvious to help him out in times of need.
Welcome back, Sergeant Oblivious, for your 7th month. Oh, it's, that's the star.
Oh, look at it. It's like just blurry. It's bouncing so fast.
Wow, how did I mess that up? It's a good thing that's not super annoying or anything. Hey, hey, hey.
Whee!
The flag's right there. And I'm still gonna die. Alright.
I got a few one-ups. Well, no, wait, those don't count. Captain Obvious is Sergeant Oblivious's unit commander. They work well together.
Jump better there. I agree with you, MTV. Eventually, we'll hit a level that's a little bit more challenging.
Dude.
Yeah, dude. What's this level called? Papa Mike.
Doo-doo.
Papa Mike. Okay.
Oh, this looks like his attempt at the beginning level.
Yeah. A lot of people tried that one.
Graham is master of Mario's move.
Yep, I'm the master. I'm the master.
You see, to the untrained eye.
Yeah. You might think.
But it's all part of a grander scheme.
Yeah. Oh, crap. That other guy come from? I know he was right there the whole time.
Can you beat Adam's time on the fish level? No!
I'm not gonna try.
How did...
Thanks. Wow. Really? That's the one where I get the passive-aggressive... This level? Alright.
It's okay if you can't do it.
You know, I don't care what's in these question mark blocks.
What was Adam's time on the fish level? Did he totally rock James's time?
Probably.
I mean, James's time was like an hour.
Didn't James take, like hours and hours?
And, like 100 lives. Ah! What the? Not only are you Wario, but you're Tennis Wario.
Waluigi.
Waluigi, sorry.
Well, because Waluigi was made for Mario Tennis.
Right, right. And you're teeny weeny Waluigi. That's like the one thing Waluigi has, is that he's tall. That's his one defining characteristic. Oh, and now he's dead.
Adam,
99 lives.
Adam did the fish level in fewer deaths than James.
46
as well.
Deaths as opposed to 79.
That's fewer.
That's fewer. Still not great, but you know, it's a tough level.
Pass touch. What does it say? Okay.
Doesn't seem so bad. I I am suspicious of this.
Hey, Paul, you want to try shrooms this
weekend? The worst.
Very nice. Okay.
The worst. This is gonna suck. You gotta kill yourself. Or not. Oh,
ha!
Hey!
Ha 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 ha! Eat it!
Got there!
So the plan was that you had to be small and avoid all the mushrooms.
Screw his plan! Plans are made to be broken. Pas tôt champignon.
Yeah.
Do not touch the mushrooms.
Don't touch mushrooms, yeah.
In French. Yeah.
I thought it said like pass touch champion because it went by so quickly. Hard. This level is hard.
MLG pro strat.
Yeah, totally. Hey, 1-ups.
Gives you exactly 3 1-ups, right?
Yeah.
Big freaking...
Why?
Bloopers. How do little ones know where to go?
I have fire flower. I'm not touching any other blocks.
Just occurred to me that...
It's a giant fish.
It's
of
a fish. It's from,
Crap.
It's like in, Finding Nemo.
Mm-hmm.
John Ratzinger's.
Ah!
Koopa's underwater. It's so weird. This is bad. That doesn't seem like a good thing.
I'm gonna try and get up there. Later, suckers. Oh. Ah!
It was a trap. It was a trap.
There was a firefight. There was a firefight.
Just like, and then scrolls on the screen, just entirely full of bullet bills. Dude, that was awesome. It's like, they'll let you get out of the level, but you pay the price.
Damn it. Here, come over here.
Looper doesn't follow you. He does what he wants.
Damn it. Oh, I see, because you can get out right here.
And then you have to try and get back down over there.
Ah! I don't think I can.
It's going to be super frustrating.
Yeah. Oh, that's the. Well, I was right there. Ow!
Ow! Ow! Oh, you don't. Ow! My feet. You don't slide down.
All right. Fair enough.
That was kind of cool. I like that level.
That level was called hard.
Doing good on your lives, anyway.
Yeah.
Oh. This is called Hidden Block. This is just like, keep jumping until you find the stupid thing. Or not. Ah! Okay, good. I was afraid that was just like, go through
what
that
what in hole. The shit, though? Oh, well, there's the hidden block.
Yay!
Okay. Okay, Ewan, bring it on. Oh, even better. Eat it! I was just gonna try and damage boost through there, but I'll take it.
Alright. That could have been scary if you didn't have the,
Why doesn't it go boing boing boing?
Because it doesn't open up and then click.
I know. But that's part of the sound.
Yeah.
It's like how the end of... It's like how the Star Trek Next Generation theme ends with the Paramount tag.
Mm. Level noob.
All right. How are these normal? How are these not easy levels?
All right. I really feel challenged here.
Hmm. Ah, bonsoir to you too, Remslider. Comment on the new emoticons game. The new emotions game. Sorry. Yeah. David Cage announced his new game. So that'll be interesting. Scuba Boy. It's Olimar.
It's the Pikmin guy?
Yeah. Captain Olimar from Pikmin. Or Scuba Boy.
It doesn't make sense that he would be underwater. He's got his little...
No. Oh, thank God there. David Cage is still making movies. Yeah. Interactive experiences. It's a shame, because I actually think that his design ideas are really neat. I just think that his, like, writing and story is garbage. Bullet Bill Barrage.
Other than the writing and story and gameplay, though. Good. Good stuff.
No, I actually don't mind the gameplay of, like, Beyond Two Dads when we played it. It was just that, like... The, like, plot was so trite.
I mean, there was some serious gameplay issues, too.
Oh, yeah. Well, that was exciting. I'm glad I waited around for that. Wait, come back to me, Mushroom. I'm sorry I ever besmirched you.
Oh, now who looks who wants the mushroom? Yeah, those were definitely not in the original Mario. Whoop.
No, I didn't say. To be clear, I did not actually enjoy playing Beyond Two Souls. I think the gameplay ideas are interesting. I would love to see ideas like that executed by someone else. Ow.
David Cage and Peter Molyneux should get together. We have good ideas, but can't actually make them work. Party.
Is there actually nothing down there? All right.
There's something down there. Death. Death is down there.
Only death lives there. Yep. It's nothing. Totally thought I got that one, but no.
Oh, no.
Huh. Okay.
Oh, yeah, right. Asian beef. I forgot about Asian beef. Remember when they made Asian beef?
Oh, yeah.
For the guy
like
that
a whole,
we,
like, mini game.
For the guy that we didn't like. And desperately tried to sabotage their date, and then the next time we met up with them, she was totally hot for him anyway.
Yeah.
Gameplay! Narrative!
Well, it was also like, what's his name? The ghost, forget what the ghost's name is.
Aiden.
Aiden, right. Was like,
well, it was whole... Aiden, but everyone said Aiden.
Right. And he was all sabotaging the thing, right? Trying to mess up her date, because apparently he was actually her brother, wasn't that?
I think so.
Spoiler.
Mario time.
And he became a ghost in the womb.
Womb ghost.
The worst kind of ghost.
Hold right and run too. Alright, well. Now we have another auto runner, kind of. At least I have to actually interact with it. Whoa! That was cool timing.
I like that the,
Yay. I did it! hidden philosophical depth? I hope it's not hidden. I like to think that mostly everyone at Loading Ready Run has respect, like, respects fellow human beings and allows for mistakes and personal self-expression.
I just like that.
Oh, and it's not a runner as well.
I like that dichotomy.
Yeah.
Of, it's like, despite playing games that have, scary stuff in them, he does still actually think people are okay.
I know what you mean. It's just a funny way of wording it. The fuck you looking at me for, Mario? You want me to do something about it, or oh no, okay, apparently not.
What are those guys doing?
I don't know, hanging around.
Oh, maybe they'll come into play, or not.
I mean, what do you want to know about Chaucer? I don't talk about stuff. Like, I don't have opportunities to go deep, as it were, when I'm streaming. Often, but
well, it's also, I mean, I always had the there's always the thing when you're streaming, like, you know, especially like something like this where you're like, you know, they're really, it's really tough, you know, dealing with some of these, holy crap.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Like, it's, you know, trying to like talk about something serious while you're kind of like half distracted.
Don't move. Wow, we hit three auto runners
in
a row. We didn't hit that many last time,
and you started with an auto runner.
Yeah. Like, I do appreciate how different they all are.
Like, I think you... Like, this one, for instance.
Yeah.
You think this person just kept adding... just kept adding these until it worked? I'm pretty sure... I think you only actually played, like, 5 levels.
I think so, yeah. I did it. I did it. I did it.
And that was the boss level.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. All right, let's try another round and see if
I gotta say, that makes me even more disappointed in Princess Peach. There wasn't anybody even there. Bowser left. There was nobody in the castle.
I see. I don't know, Chaucer. I guess it just doesn't come up for me as much. Like I said, I agree with Alex on that stuff. I just don't, I don't know. Alex is pretty open about, his own personal sort of struggles, and, I think it comes up on stream for him more because he is so open, and so people who are encountering similar problems.
He does his sort of the ask stuff. And,
yeah.
And
I also have an Ask FM, by the way, and if you have any questions about Loading Ready Run stuff, please don't bother Alex, because 90% of the time he doesn't know the answer and just has to be like, that's a question for Graham. I have my own. For some reason, he gets all the, like, what does Loading Ready Run think of this? And he's like,
I like Bowser left to make another castle because that one was crap.
Yeah.
It should be different little guys each time. There's something about 100 little pairs of Mario feet coming in.
I kind of like it. This one's mine. Get out. This one's mine too. I'm taking it with me.
Maybe you needed one of those.
Ah! Ah! The timing is so weird.
And it's the opposite from...
Hang on, what if I do this? Nope! No shit!
No! You need that one! The timing, not only is it annoying, but it's also the opposite of what Shovel Knight is, right?
Yeah. Whoops. I got that one. Alright! Ooh, that one goes way higher. No, come back! I want the thing!
Too many doors. What is going on?
Wow. I'm pretty vocal about my opinions too, Meme Drake.
I mean, I guess, I don't know, for me it's more, it's, I guess it's like, I mean, I can be fairly vocal about my opinions, but I usually don't like, ooh, what's that hat? Oh, wow, I haven't seen that one.
Ah!
But like, I'm vocal about my opinions, but I don't like, I tend to not like volunteer them for no reason, I guess. Or for, you know, unless somebody like asks me about it, if I don't have any particular reason to state my opinion on a subject, I don't feel the need to.
I know, No Man's Sky is coming out in June. Birthday present.
I was like, June! Wait, June's a long time away. Oh.
I know, but at least they've said when it's coming out.
Currently, a man has... That's not a wall.
That was a wall.
It's like, currently, a man has the sky, but by June, we're going to wrestle it away from him. Mm-hmm. And then it'll be No Man's Sky.
Oh, if you're talking about him on his own streams, yeah, I was like, Alex? You were like, Alex streams more often. I was like, what? But yeah, no, because he does his own stuff at home.
Yeah, and I think there's also an aspect of like... I think when you're, if you're streaming from home, it can be a little bit more kind of, I don't know. Especially if you're like streaming on your own channel or whatever. It lends itself to being a little bit more introspective, maybe. Still counts!
I won! Oh, that's true. Also, horror games do bring up gender representation and mental health a lot more than other genres.
I remember that way back, I think it might have been in ENN days.
Or that's another reason I had problems, by the way, with Beyond Two Souls.
But I think it may have been back in ENN days, but at least a while, there was a thing.
You could just walk on lava if you have a...
Did not know that. But we did a story on ENN or Checkpoint about there was a game jam that was happening that was... The whole premise of the game jam was make a horror game that isn't set in an insane asylum.
Yeah.
Because, God... No, there's actually ground underneath
it. Oh, I didn't even see it.
Because, damn it, there's so many of those. And you know, it sort of perpetuates this kind of idea that... It's all really scary, right?
Oh, no worries at all, Chaucer. No, absolutely no worries. It's F-Zero, hold right to win. Okay. Hey, I'm Captain Falcon, and we're racing. I just found the wording of the question funny. It was just like, Even though he plays violent games and stuff, Alex is kind of philosophical. Are you philosophical? Well, are you?
It's like, even though he plays violent games, he still cares about people.
Mm-hmm.
It's like...
And we know what you meant. Believe me. We're not trying to rag on you at all. We're just sort of funny.
It's true. Alex also does, I mean, just in the sense of video games, Alex does have, shall we say, quite strong opinions on certain subjects.
He sure does. Excuse me a moment.
Oi.
Here you go. I'll be right back.
These nuts. I don't know what I'm doing.
I don't know what I'm doing with these nuts. But I'm playing this game, apparently. Maybe Yoshi in here? What the? Not only am I Yoshi in the Bowser copter, but I have dancing girls! I have so many different power-ups right now. I think I have the most number of power-ups you can have. Whoop. Okay. I don't... That was a weird game. Eh.
What's going on?
That was like in Mario 3, you can get the Super P-Wing that allows you to just fly over the level completely.
Mm-hmm.
It was like that, except they just gave me the Bowser copter to beat it, and I was like, okay, I guess I'll start flying. And then I just flew over the whole level.
This level, favorite name of the day, Questionable Cavern. I can see that cat card. I don't know about this cavern. It's a little questionable.
This is where they mine for question blocks. This is where question blocks come from. I was about to say, there's got to be something in one of these, but of course there doesn't. So that's the interesting thing about this, the Mario Maker stuff, is they don't necessarily have to follow the rules of, like...
Of game design.
Of good game design.
It's like, why is that there? I don't know.
It's funny.
Felt like it. Oh, because seeing it there made me think that, you know, X, Y, or Z. Oh, really? Oh, I didn't even think about that. No, I just put it there for whatevers. You can, on those guys, in New Super Mario, you can use the shoulder button to spin jump off them.
Oh, really?
Yeah, off of Spinies and the Piranha Plants, but not the, like, actual spike things.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Why? I wonder if you can spin jump off some spiky things, why not other spiky things?
That does bug me, and that's not Mario Maker's fault. Like, that guy you can spin jump off of.
And I can go back and spin.
Fair enough.
I was about to, and I was like, wait a minute. No,
the spin jump also helps you, like, move a little further laterally.
It gives you a bit of a boost.
Yeah. Oh, and thwomps. You can spin jump off thwomps, which is very useful.
Okay.
But not big spinning blades. Yoshi can do that.
Yoshi's just invulnerable. His feet are invulnerable.
Basically. He's got very thick boots.
Oh, he goes around barefoot all the time. So the pads of his feet are very...
Is he? I would swear he's wearing little booties.
I don't know. I guess it could go...
Just spin jump them.
Oh, have to hit him.
Dark paint with the shoulder buttons.
Oh, no. Shouldn't spin jump be one of the other buttons?
It lets you run and spin jump at the same time. Like, hold down the run button.
Right, right. But traditionally, it is.
Yeah, yeah. Yoshi does have little boots.
Does he?
Yeah, he's got little booties. They look like Mario's boots.
But they're better, I guess. Yoshis never talk, right? Even to each other.
They say Yoshi.
Well, he's kind of go... They never actually talk.
No.
Even in, like, the Yoshi's Island stuff.
I assume that, much like cats, that is a noise that they use to communicate with plumbers.
And so they don't actually need to talk to each other?
Yeah.
They just, whatever, smell each other's butts and stuff. Ha-ha! Yes, that was unnecessary.
See, now I want to find a way to phrase that question better. How's this? What's a belief that you find, a belief you have, that conflicts with the way you present yourself? I don't know how I present myself. I don't know if I have... I don't know what your impression of me is, so I don't know if I have a belief that conflicts with that. I know that... I mean, most of you know now, but I know that for a while when people found out that I watched WWE wrestling, they were like, really? Because it seemed out of character for me.
What are you doing? You're a plant with wings. What are you doing?
What are you doing with yourself? This is where they mine the blocks.
Yeah. This is highly, highly questionable.
Huh. You got there.
This is before they put anything good in the blocks, because it's just still the mining.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I like to think that I present myself fairly accurately.
Yeah.
I certainly are not trying to present myself in a way that...
I guess... Castillo the Pyramid Castle. I guess you won't know and I won't know until I say something that you find is out of your idea of my character.
I mean, I was about to say I'm certainly not deliberately hiding an aspect of myself, but if I was deliberately hiding an aspect of myself, I wouldn't tell you now, would I?
Uh-huh.
So, you know. Take that as you will. What?
Oh, what dear. Is happening?
Oh dear.
Nope.
Oh,
dead. Nope. Oh, not nope. Dead. Could it? Oh, nope. Could have bounced.
Could it? Could have? Would have? Should have?
Yeah. It's interesting, Foxmore. I'm working on something that I'll probably show off on stream at some point. I think Graham is just like his Commodore Hustle version. I'm glad you have the Kappa there. I do not want to be like my Commodore Hustle self.
Yeah, I think when, like, we started doing Commodore Hustle and that kind of stuff, people did think that I was, like, more into the, like, Linux stuff and things like that.
These guys you can't.
I thought for a sec that I could stand at the top of them.
You can... Nope, I guess not.
Nope. Okay.
See if you can jump over him. Yeah. Clear it! Whoa!
That... He went far... And
why do these keep going up?
Oh, there's a guy at the bottom.
Oh.
I'm like, damn it.
Sensetaku, I haven't finished the Festival of the Lost, isn't until the 9th, but I've got some of the masks.
Yeah, it may surprise you to know that, unlike our Commodore Hustle characters, we're not all psychopaths.
You can fly.
Aha! Got there. Whoop.
Oh, cool. Oh. Still counts!
Still counts! Bye, everybody! So many leaves. It's like autumn down here. How was that a pyramid castle?
Because it went up at the... There was like an angle thing.
Ha ha. were dot 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 all psychopaths. What?
Oh, what the shit?
I was something and then I wasn't.
You were something and then you were nothing.
What did I turn into? Star Fox? What the?
You just gotta go.
Just gotta run?
Yeah.
I'm a Arwing. But with feet. Help! Help!
What is happening?
Why is that a thing?
And now it's what? What is what was any? What the hell?
Why is an Arwing with feet? Couldn't they just actually have like fox? And then it turns into a flying thing when you're running.
That's pretty funny. So you say that, Chef of Death, because Beej and Alex don't drink.
So yeah, drinking with them, I mean, I'm not going to say it'll be boring, because, you know, you can talk to them and stuff, but I feel like it won't be quite the effect you're looking for.
Why is that there? I don't think you go in that tube.
Yeah, you're probably right. Trap tube. Watch as the door makes you go up the tube. Flying piranha plants just... And now because of Shovel Knight, I think that there's a secret passage there. For, like, bombing.
Mm.
You know, that little indent?
Yeah. Alex don't drink. I didn't know that. Yeah, they and Paul.
Yeah, we are the teetotaler crew. It's not actually a thing.
No.
But maybe it should be. It should be.
It. I guess it would be a thing if any of us like cared.
Yeah.
But no one else gives a shit about anyone's decisions to drink or not drink. Okay. Sure. Die for no reason.
Good chance to test it out. Nope. Okay. There's weird little flame things down there. There's lava down there, I think.
Ersatz morals? I believe you? When did I say that?
What?
You shouldn't pee with an erection. Okay, so you shouldn't force yourself to pee if you have an erection, because there's a sphincter way up inside you that stops you from doing that so that you don't inadvertently pee while you have a boner. And if you try and force that rather than waiting like a little while for your boner to go down, then that sphincter gets less good at doing its job, and then as you get older you get dribbly. There you go. Canadian sexual education system.
I don't know if that's not where that came from.
Well, I learned it a while ago.
But from school?
Pretty sure.
That's good. That's just a general good rule of thumb. Don't override your sphincter.
Yeah.
It's probably doing what it's supposed to do.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Seriously though, when did I say that? That's so weird. Why'd you star that one?
Yeah, that's kind of cool.
I don't get the name of that level, but whatever. High up in the mushroom skies.
Oh, that sounds nice. Wait, no. Thank you.
like a down octave
what the
ghost house theme, but on an airship.
Not a fan of these ba-bombs just kind of falling from the sky. Like that. No, not a fan. Not a fan.
Yeah, I wouldn't be.
Also, ooh,
pick one of those guys up and throw him at the... Goodbye. Ooh, pick that guy up.
Nope. Don't.
I hate that sound effect so much. Haha!
Didn't even use the explosion nature of it.
I wouldn't stand there.
Damn it.
I didn't know that you could set sound effects to Mario, and I'm kind of annoyed that you can.
Stop!
Oh, good one. You got a twofer out of that.
Wait, I want to get on... I will get on you! Go! Up! Up! Aha! Nope! No! Oh, I see. It's there's a bunch of dudes up there in clouds throwing the bombs. Why do I keep getting that?
Well, cheers, Foxmore's mom. Thanks very much. Yeah, I do hum along to this song a lot. Look, I played a lot of Super Mario World.
Yep.
Back in the day in this instance, the day being when Super Mario World was new. I realize that the definition of when the day is changes for everybody, depending on what the hell's going on. That guy's gonna get up in a second. Everyone has different definitions of when the day is.
What was that?
I don't know. You should get that mushroom. Where? Or whatever it is. It was the question block.
No!
The
worst.
I'm so sorry.
I blame you.
Yeah, that's fair. I accept it.
It's the thing that makes me big and then they give me a mushroom right away. I don't understand.
Magnus 1, we've made some levels. Mostly we play other people's. I don't know, I think it's a little more entertaining for a stream to play than make. But, that depends on what you're into. I hate that noise, too.
Oh, crap. Thought it was gonna go away. I like the buzzy beetle things. That they just like when you stand up and be like, oh crap, gotta go up! Like rather than going down because there's more weight on them. I'm kind of digging this level though.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of cool. Not really an airship. It sort of acts like an airship, but it ain't. It's got like ground and stuff on it. Stop it! Fine. Won't do that.
Wow.
I don't like that.
That's true, Seamus. Yeah, I know that Dan Floyd isn't with them anymore, but do you know if Extra Credit still streams game design streams? Because Mario Maker would be a great thing for them to stream.
I mean, I know Extra Credits is still doing all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, but Dan was doing most of their streaming, so I just don't know if they still do a bunch of... Like, he would do, like, game design streams.
I didn't realize Dan wasn't with them anymore.
Yep, he got a job at Blizzard.
Job. I want to see what's up here.
Oh, that's where they're coming from!
Yeah, this guy's throwing them.
Oh, okay.
Do I like Star Wars? Yes. These are the kind of tough questions.
Yeah, not Dan Floyd. Different Dan. Sorry. Again, there have been three Dans with extra credits. Sorry. Dan Floyd is the main Dan. Did I say Dan Floyd?
No, you just said Dan, I assumed Dan Floyd.
Sorry. Dan Emmons was the guy who did their streams.
Oh.
Former of Wizards of the Coast. Sorry. No, Dan is like half of actual extra credits, the show.
Yeah, that's why I was confused. I was like... Yeah.
Well, there's three Dans that are involved with extra credits.
I say this as somebody who's has Dan as my brother. That's too many Dans. Go away. I really want to know what's making that noise. Good thing we have so many lives. I'm gonna need them all. I don't like the randomness of this level. You know,
it is. Someone mentioned it. It is a little Frankensteinish.
What is this level?
Yeah, it's sort of like a bunch of different things kind of cobbled together.
Well, I mean the randomness in the sense of like the bombs coming from the top, because it means like you can't actually like lock it down, like master it.
No, I think it means you need to keep moving, right? Because if you hang around in one place, then you're just going to keep getting bombs.
Yeah, but even if you're moving, they come down and hit you.
QWERTY, we have streamed emulated games. Lots.
Yeah. I did a few on my stream. Anything that you see us playing that is from like Super Nintendo or earlier.
Hey, it occurs gonna be you guys would be perfectly able to ask, what are the legal ramifications of backing the creators of fan content on Patreon? Oh, you mean like fan art?
What are the legal ramifications of backing?
Of like, so there's a lot of people on Patreon. I don't know about fan fiction, but there's a lot of people on Patreon who do like fan art.
Right.
And they're very, very successful. I don't know. Yeah, try.
Yeah. Why
I don't know what you mean. Like,
why would there be legal ramifications of backing somebody?
Yeah, like, you mean for you?
I mean, the people doing the fan art could theoretically have legal ramifications, although I don't think any company would ever actually prosecute that.
Yeah.
I mean...
It depends on how much money they're making, I guess.
It depends on what they're selling. I guess it's the idea of it being that once they have a Patreon, they are doing it for money.
I guess.
Or they're, like, selling it, so it's sort of a commercial venture, but... I mean, yeah. Strictly speaking, most fan art is violating copyright law in some way. Depending on how transformative it is. And this is also the worst band ever is apparently around.
What the hell?
Now you're in a different game. you support at this level, you get access to more of the... the videos, or more of the pictures, right? So there's a more, like, direct relationship between spending money and getting the pictures. I feel like that would probably be more...
No, I want to...
Of course, this is all, assuming that you can get by under fair use stuff.
What the shit?
In a lot of cases, you might be able to.
Can't see ground. What the hell is this? Alright.
Were you supposed to have the jumpy hat, maybe?
I guess I just wasn't supposed to go that way.
But, anyway. Copyright is always obviously is always a very tricky matter. It's especially weird for us because the laws in Canada are different than the laws in America. But, of course, a lot of our stuff is...
Oh, hang on.
On American,
Oh, I missed it.
On American sources.
Oh, what? I'm still alive.
So the laws are a little bit weird.
I bet it was supposed to go in one of those tubes.
Frankly, we don't want to bother. We generally don't want to figure it out, so we'll keep clear of anything that would be even remotely considered it. This is a very confusing
moment. And I died again. Alright, what I'm learning is don't go through any of the doors.
Oh, there's the end.
Oh, good. Oh, good for you.
Yep. Laws in different countries are different. I mean, that's sort of a very flippant thing to say. But because Canada and America do share a lot of things, it is worthwhile to note, that in a lot of cases they're sort of... for a lot of laws, they are very similar or the same, but there are a few things that work a little differently. This level is, conceptually muddy at best.
He's being very kind.
Gap filler, the difference between Creative Commons and no copyright is actually quite a lot. I mean, things that are under Creative Commons are fully under copyright, but they just have an implicit license granted as part of the Creative Commons thing to allow people to do certain things. But what it is it allows a creator to have some control over how their stuff is used without... still allow it to be used in a, for allow people to reuse it, but have some control over that.
Aztren with a 4-month resub. Welcome back, Aztren. Thank you.
And there are different flavors of Creative Commons. You can set different things. And the whole idea is that it's sort of a turnkey system of licensing that, covers lots of different situations for like,
That's a Kaizo block.
Basically making it so that you can, you can keep something under copyright and not just release it for fair use, but you can still... How high is it going to go?
The double.
But you can release it and allow people to reuse it and, remix your product or do whatever you want, but also...
Yeah, I knew it.
But also retain some kind of copyright, you know.
I don't think so, Chaucer. You are in no way in legal danger for supporting someone who makes fan art on Patreon.
No, certainly not. I mean, you're not in any danger buying a copyrighted work either. Like, paying money for a work that violates copyright isn't the problem. receiving money for a work that violates copyright. That's the problem.
Yeah, that's what people don't like.
It has a thing on his head.
Damn it. I'm trying to pick it up.
They have
Naxo Chills with 21 free sub. Welcome back, Naxo Chills. Thank you for subscribing.
Creative Commons is super cool, actually. A lot of the content we produce for Learning Way Run is released under Creative Commons. And we've used a lot of Creative Commons stuff in our stuff.
Hell yeah.
And it's sort of a... it's a neat way to allow, you know, this sort of collaboration and stuff, which is really what copyright is for in a lot of ways, right? Like, the original idea behind copyright is this thing where you can release things. I mean, trademarking and copyright are closely related, but this idea that you can release something to the world and let people see it and enjoy it without having to worry about somebody stealing it, mm-hmm. is the idea behind copyright. And the Creative Commons is just sort of a way of legally codifying the idea where you're like, yeah, I'm totally cool with somebody using, you know, using my work to do something cool with, or, you know, to do like a remix or whatever. I'm maybe not so cool having, you know, if you really just release something under no copyright, then, like, you know, Sony can just be like, I'm gonna take this.
Yeah.
Which is a little bit of a different situation. It's basically like, I mean, they were basically trying to emulate some of the open source software licenses in the real world, basically, is a lot of what Creative Commons is about. You know, the GNU license or the MIT license.
What I'm trying to do, in case it's not clear, is first of all, remember that fucking block is there. I'm trying to, oh, geez, we're into Cam's time.
Sorry, Cam.
What are you playing today? Oh, right, Mass Effect.
Nice.
Okay, don't know why that's there. Oh,
this
great.
Going to be bad.
Great. Well, what the crap? Oh, almost got there. Alright, well, that level's not going to get beat anytime soon, so we should get out of here so Cam can have his stream.
Yep. Alright, well, thank you everybody very much for watching. We'll probably move on to a different game next week.
There it is.
I don't know what that game will be yet. I feel like we had an idea of a game, and now I've forgotten what that was. So
we did,
we'll figure
and I don't
it out.
Know.
Anyway, it'll be awesome. I guarantee.
I don't think we can follow through on that. Who knows?
I think it'd be awesome.
Who knows?
Anyway, I'm not saying the game will be awesome. I'm saying the stream will be awesome.
We'll make it great.
Yes.
All right. Thanks for watching, everybody. Yeah. We're going to run some commercials on the way out. Appreciate it if you let those run. And Cam will be on in a few minutes with Mass Effect. And then tomorrow,
always,
James. James is on tomorrow morning.
If you missed anything, you can check out the replay channel, youtube.com/loadingreadylive. And Ian has done an awesome job of getting us up to date on that. So mm-hmm. you can check out all the cool stuff that has been going on.
Yeah.
And thank you, everybody, who has been subscribing and following and supporting our Patreon. And, yeah. Oh, the survey we can mention, actually.
Yeah, right.
I haven't mentioned that in a while, but...
That's true. I think we've probably gotten most of the people watching, but yeah, there's the survey, which someone will pop up in chat, which you can check out for...
Yeah, we're just...
So we can find out who all you are.
We're just trying to get some an idea of some info for future planning purposes.
Mm-hmm. So
check that out if you haven't filled it out already.
All right. We're going to take off, and see you guys later.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.